Guys, with this new exercise, we want to see functionality of the transformer in Powerfactory. So as usual, let's go through the element and type information, and then let's perform some simple calculation by using our radial model. So let's go into Powerfactory. Transformer, the element, that's the one you see, the information you see displayed right now. The name, of course, the type of transformer. The connection point, high voltage and low voltage side, and if we have any number of parallel transformers. And then under the load flow tab, we can actually see the only part of the transformer that we can actually dispatch, which is the tap. Right now, tap position equal to zero. That means that the tap is a neutral position. If we see the type information, you can see that right now our type transformer has this size, voltage levels, vector group, if it is a star or a delta connected transformer, short circuit voltage, which is 12%, ratio X over R, because right now the resistance is equal to zero, so the ratio is close to be infinite. And then on the low flow information, on the low flow tab, we see information about magnetization impedance, which right now does not exist, so the impedance is infinite. And the tap, we can have two taps. Right now we just have one located on the high voltage side. The tap type is an tap changer that affects the ratio, but without shifting the phases. The additional voltage per tap is equal to 1%, and we are not shifting, of course, any phase, because that's not the purpose of our transformer. And then we have a neutral position equal to zero, minimum and maximum position 10. So we can go plus minus 10% around the nominal transformation rate of the transformer. So let's actually change the transformer, and let's actually pull the one that has also resistances and shunt elements. So you see the trend now, we have also some magnetization accounted for. Tap is always the same, and we do have also a little bit of resistance. So we change this one, and of course we change also the twin. We perform a load flow, and we have our situation here, which is not very much different from before, because in the end, losses induced by the transformers are quite limited. So now let's actually see what can we use the tap changer for. So let's say that we want to get the load up to 300 megawatt, and we want to keep all voltages between 95% and 105%. So let's redispatch our load, 300 megawatt, run the load flow again, and then we see that the voltage profile get a little bit low, so that's not very nice voltage value to maintain. So right now the deviations are not very large, and we have a lot of flexibility from both the tap and also the voltage level of the generator. So right now we can actually play a little bit with the tap on this side. And for instance, you can see that we can, since the voltage is set on the low voltage and we want to increase the high voltage side, then we need to stretch, we need to elongate the transformer a little bit. So we need to increase the tap position so that the transformation ratio increases a little bit. So let's say 5%. You will see that from 97.6%, we will get a bit higher. So we get at this point, so that's a little bit 4% increase pretty much. And and then we can also do the other job on the other transformer. So in this case, however, since we need to raise the voltage on the low voltage side of the transformer, then we need to shorten the transformer a little bit. So we need to reduce the tap position, let's say minus 5. That should probably do. Not quite. So we need to actually get this one a little bit more. And then we have all voltage values that are 95%. If we want to improve even further, then we may of course want to consider coordinating this voltage, this tapping action with the voltage set by the generator. And in case we would be able to improve a little bit the voltage profile and get something like that. Let's be careful, as always, that raising the voltage too much and tapping too much, because we want to compensate for a very high voltage drop, could actually be a little bit risky, because we could end up on some voltage at some nodes that gets too high. So careful with that. Now let's also provide 100 megawatt more. And let's see the situation. You see that right now, of course, we are worsening a lot the situation in the grid because of this huge amount of reactive power that you are moving throughout the system. I remind you that the line is 100 kilometer long, so it's a quite long line for a 220 kV, and the amount of reactive power compared to the rating of the line is also quite a lot. So right now you see that the voltage levels at the receiving ends are not acceptable. So we need to actually boost a little bit the different action. So for instance, we may want to increase a little bit this tap and decrease the other one a bit further. And we can get some acceptable values. That the voltage down here would not really be the best voltage to have in a steady situation. So I would definitely not recommend to keep this operating point with this 100 megabar down here. But if that's necessary, then that could be a feasible operation. One thing we may notice, one final thing we may notice, is that by tapping and of course by increasing the voltage values throughout the grid, we have two beneficial effects. The first one is that we are reducing the current on the line, meaning that we'll be reducing the magnetization of the line. So the X I square that the line is consuming. And at the same time, by raising the voltage, we are improving the capacity compensation, the natural capacity compensation provided by the line because of higher voltage and therefore higher capacitive power generated. Just to get a comparison, you can see here the amount of reactive power provided by the generator is 241 megawatt. And if we reset the tap to the neutral position, so we don't get any benefit from the tap changer, the reactive power provided by the generator will be much, much more, because of the fact that the voltage at both ends of the line decreased, the current increased a lot, so the line is not really supporting the reactive power balance in the system. That's pretty much it for the transformer.